As part of verification, let's check that the reactions balance the applied load, that is, the structure is in equilibrium. Before I get into ANSYS, I want to indicate how ANSYS calculates a reaction. If I go back to this slide on potential energy minimization, okay, the work due to external forces is given by this term, and this is nothing but UY3, so it's PUY3. And when you derive the algebraic equation from, you know, this minimizing the potential energy with respect to UY3, okay, when you differentiate that with respect to UY3, you will get P. So the algebraic equation will relate this degree of these 4 degrees of freedom to P, and it'll be a linear relationship. Correspondingly, okay, here you have a reaction, right? Because of you're fixing the beam over there, so you have a reaction. And by analogy, when you take the derivative of the potential energy with respect to UY1, okay, that has to be zero. And that's true because if I perturb UY1 by a little bit, the potential energy has to increase, okay? Now, this relationship, you know, if you derive it, what you will get is a relationship between R and these degrees of freedom, okay? So you should think of it as analogy, and this is very similar to what I talked about in the big ideas in finite element analysis. So in the first step, you determine these 2 degrees of freedom from the displacement, from the, you know, essential boundary conditions. Then you determine these degrees of freedom by inverting an algebraic equation. And then in the third step, you derive the reactions from these degrees of freedom that are now known. So let's get ANSYS to do that. If I go to ANSYS and select solution and probe force reaction, okay, everywhere I have, you know, displacement constraints or rotation constraints, I'll get a reaction. So here I have it only at the fixed support. Ignore weak springs, and then let me evaluate that. Okay, and if I scroll down here, that's 8,000 newtons in the global coordinate system, okay? And that balances the 8,000 newtons load that we applied down. Similarly, you can check the moment reaction. Everything I said about the moment reaction also apply, about the force reaction also applies to the moment reaction, except that now, you know, the moment reaction is calculated from an equation where you're minimizing the potential energy with respect to the rotational degrees of freedom. Okay, so this is an important verification check, and it passes.